Why don't you stand down one step? If you stand down one step. One, two. All right. A no hitter tonight. You been involved in those before?
No, it's my first time.
What was it like coming into the ninth and the two guys before you, you know, shut them out down at that point?
You just don't want to be the guy to go up and hit. Once you get that deep in the game, Fabio threw great, first game into his job. So you just want to keep it going.
What was it like out there that final out?
Excited. Yeah, we can get it done.
This is a big win for you guys tonight?
Yeah, hopefully we can get rolling. You know, we struggled a little bit this last week. Won the last two, hoping this will get us going.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, your comments on tonight's performance, especially from the pitching staff.
Yeah, obviously it's fantastic. Pitching performance, anytime you have a no-hitter. I've been around one in 2004 when I was with the Yankees. We battled Quick, Elvis Quesada, threw one against South Bend in 04. It's a little different when you have three guys doing it. It's still special, but it's not the same as when one guy does it. But it doesn't make it any less of a feat. But a great job by Fabio Martinez, Kyle Hurst, and then Mike Kinney to finish the ballgame.
Yeah. Fabio, man, he's really throwing heat out there.
Yeah, he's got a great arm, and he's got a really hard breaking ball, and even his change is pretty hard. He's a young guy, and he needs to harness his energy and throw low strikes, but he's on the right direction.
What do you think this will mean for the team tonight, winning like this?
The way we've been playing, every win's big for us, coming in this fashion, and our guys are getting better. We knew we were going to take some lumps. I'd much rather take some lumps early in the year than in the middle or the end of the season. But, yeah, this club, we're excited. We're going to keep going.
Thanks, Bill. Appreciate it. 1-2, 1-2.
Abe, two no-hitters, two nights in a row. Last night, Arkansas, Ryan Brazier. Tonight, combined no-hitter, Fabio and everybody else for the Kernels. Pretty unique.
Oh, fantastic accomplishment, two nights in a row. Obviously, yeah, they're special every time out, but to get them two nights in a row is almost impossible. But congratulations to those pitchers who threw those no-hitters and to the catchers who put down the right fingers.
Well, certainly the catching had something to do with it, too. But
and the people playing defense behind him, too, had a lot to do with it.
And that's certainly true as well. And with Fabio going only five innings, I know in the minor leagues we definitely work pitch count.
Right.
Ryan Brazier went full game last night, but with Fabio, I would assume no thoughts at all letting him go more than his pitch count.
No, it's too early in the season, especially. We just want to make sure that he remains healthy throughout the season, and so pretty strict pitch count.
Abe, thanks a lot.
You bet.
When you came in the game?
Yeah, it's hard not to know.
What are you thinking then in the ninth inning? What's kind of going through your mind?
You want to be the guy to go up the hit. Probably go through great, hurts too well. So you want to be the guy to go up the hit.
It's kind of weird because they seem like there's so many base runners, but not one hit.
Yeah.
Drew Green is a little strange.
Yeah, they had some runners on, definitely throughout the game, but no hits.
Yeah. Is this the first one that you've been a part of in college or high school?
No,
or
this is the first one I've been a part of.
Is it? So what are you guys going to do to celebrate?
You three? I think we got a 2 o'clock game tomorrow, so we'll be here early.
You guys ought to at least go have a couple beers or something to celebrate.
We'll see.
Congratulations. Thanks. Appreciate it.
Probably it's awesome. It's awesome for the guys. You know, just not the same to me as a no hitter, as that one pitcher no hitter. You know, you don't have the same, but it's great. And the neat thing for them is three guys get to be a part of it. So obviously you like that, and three guys are a part of it.
And they had an awful lot of base runners too. It was kind of weird.
Right. Yeah. And that's
the whole thing.
Yeah. And that sort of takes. You know, it's a shutout, and it's much needed for us.
Well, Michael Briskowski, thank you so much for being part of fun, excitement, and history. 3-0 Kernels, and we're going to tell you what's up for tomorrow. This no-hitter has elevated the Kernels' record to 10-12. I will give Bill Fletcher a heads up. Bill, our final out cue, so to speak, will be Michael's call of that final out to complete the combined no-hitter. We'll fade it back to you after that call, Bill. But right now, let's look ahead. We have 3-day games on the horizon tomorrow afternoon, the first of 3-day games. And you'll hear from Bob Brooks at 1:40 on the South Slope Communications Triple Play Show. He'll be joined by Colonel Utility Man Kevin Ramos. And perhaps we can get Abe Flores to join us during the broadcast tomorrow to talk not only about Ryan Brazier's no-hitter last night in Arkansas for the Travelers, but the combined no-hitter he witnessed this evening by Fabio Martinez, Kyle Hurst, and Mike Kinney. So we'll greet you at 1:40 tomorrow afternoon. I want to thank our post-game guests on the Colonel's Curtain Call, Vern, Dale Brote, Steve Smith of FutureAngels.com. Remember, you can go there to see the final top of the ninth inning tonight and tomorrow on FutureAngels.com, and also Sonia Massey, the strike force leader of the Kernels. Also, thanks to Mike Briskowski. Michael, it's just, when you come to the ballpark, it's a joy because you just are never, ever sure what's going to unfold, and it was something tonight. And thanks to Bill Fletcher for his kind, complimentary comments about this broadcast. Most of all, thanks to you all for tuning in. As we say, whether the Kernels win or lose, our goal, our mission, our responsibility, and our joy is to be a companion and to be a familiar and trusted name and friend and to keep you company. We did tonight a 3-0 Colonel no-hit win over Kane County. And here is Michael Briskowski's call, and then you'll hear from Bill Fletcher. Here is the final out of tonight's Colonel no-hit win over the Cougars.
1-2, the count remains to Franklin Hernandez. Crowd on their feet. Kenny staring over his glove. Gets his sign, the 1-2 pitch. Down the middle, strike three, and the Cedar Rapids Colonels have thrown a no-hitter. Fabio Martinez, Kyle Hurst, and Mike Kinney combined for a Cedar Rapids Colonels no-hitter and a 3-0 victory over the Kane County Cougars as the Colonels celebrate at the pitcher's mound, and the Colonels win game one of this 4-game series against the Kane County Cougars.